I'm Dr. Michelle Lee, a board-certified ophthalmologist, and today I want to talk about some of the things that you can do prior to seeing your eye surgeon to talk about cataracts and cataract surgery. A cataract is a dirty lens inside your eye that gets progressively dirty as we get older. At some point, you will either notice that you're struggling to do the things that you want to or need to do because of your vision, or perhaps your quality of vision just isn't the same as it used to be and is not conducive to your lifestyle. Once you start to notice that your vision is not quite what it used to be, you will do some research and find an eye surgeon with a good reputation. Then the next step is meeting with your surgeon to discuss whether cataract surgery is the right option for you at this time, the risks and benefits to cataract surgery, and figure out which lenses would be the right fit for you. There is a lot that needs to be discussed in this short appointment. So what can you do to maximize your experience and prepare for your cataract surgery consultation? My first tip is to do some research ahead of time and think about what kind of lenses you want for your cataract surgery. During surgery, your cataract surgeon will replace the dirty lens inside the eye with a plastic lens, and that lens will stay in your eye forever. The most stressful feeling ever is trying to make a decision about a lens that might potentially be in your eye for the rest of your life without having done any research and considering all your options ahead of time. So with so many lens choices out there, you will want to have an idea of what your goals are after cataract surgery. First of all, are you okay with wearing glasses? If you are, then you may just want to consider your standard monofocal lens, which is a lens that is the same power throughout. It does not correct for astigmatism or give you a range in vision, but if you are okay with wearing glasses or you're completely used to it, this can be an easy option for you. Do you have astigmatism? Astigmatism is when your cornea, or the front of your eye, is shaped more like a football rather than a basketball. And if you have enough astigmatism, you might want to consider a lens to offset some of that astigmatism. This is called a toric lens, and toric lenses have different powers on different axes just to offset the shape of your cornea. What if you want to consider an option without glasses for reading? If that's the case, you can talk to your doctor about monovision, which is when we set one eye for distance and one eye for near. And this can be a good option, especially if you've tried monovision successfully in the past. But talk to your eye doctor because this option might not be for everybody. If you want to be completely glasses free and you've tried monovision or you have no interest in monovision, another lens you can discuss with your doctor is a multifocal lens. Generally speaking, these are lenses that help you look at distance, computer, and reading all without glasses. And for most people, this can be a great option to be glasses free. There are some instances where having a multifocal lens may not be an option for you. For example, if you have any eye disease, like any corneal irregularities or macular degeneration or glaucoma. So discuss this with your eye doctor and see if you are a good candidate for this type of lens. If you have a history of refractive surgery like LASIK or RK or PRK, you might want to talk to your doctor about the options available. After prior refractive surgery, unfortunately, your lens calculations may not be as accurate. You may want to talk to your eye doctor about a light adjustable lens. These are lenses that can actually be adjusted after cataract surgery and locked in when you're happy with your vision. My next tip is to confirm which eye is your dominant eye. Just like we all have a dominant hand, we have a dominant eye, and you can actually check this at home. The reason why you might want to check your eye dominance at home before your appointment with your cataract surgery is that this is very important information that may help, especially if you're considering monovision or some version of monovision for your cataract surgery. While your doctor may check for eye dominance in the office, I think it's not a bad idea to check at home because this is something that we just don't want to get wrong. To check eye dominance, you will want to extend your arms all the way out and make a small triangle or diamond with your hands. With both eyes open, move the little triangle until you can see a corner of a mirror or a distant object like a clock. Close your left eye. Can you still see the image? If you can see it, you are right eye dominant because you are looking out of your right eye. If the image is not visible, then you are left eye dominant. Another very important tip I have is to prepare your eye history. Do you have an eye that is amblyopic, meaning that that eye is weaker than the other? Or do you have a history of crossed eyes or lazy eye? This is important information to have because if you have a weaker eye, this will impact the type of lenses that your doctor might recommend. Any history of LASIK, PRK, or RK refractive surgery, even though your doctor will hopefully be able to see your LASIK flap or your RK incisions, definitely emphasize that you've had a history of refractive surgery. This is especially important because a history of refractive surgery will change the way we calculate the lens that goes inside of your eye, and you definitely don't want that to be wrong. Also, the type of lenses that we may offer will differ as well. Do you have glaucoma? If you have a history of glaucoma and are on eye drops, you may actually benefit from a minimally invasive glaucoma surgery or MIGS procedure. This can be done at the same time as cataract surgery and may decrease your dependence on at least one of your eye drops. Also, a history of moderate to severe glaucoma may actually change the kind of lenses that your doctor would recommend for you. Finally, do you have a history of trauma, either head trauma or injury around your eyes? This is important to know ahead of time because a history of head or eye trauma will also increase the chance of a complication during surgery. So it's good to let your eye surgeon know because they may change the way they do your surgery based on your history. My next important tip is to aggressively treat your dry eye. Before your eye surgery, you want your dry eye to be as optimal as possible because any issues with dryness or inflammation on your ocular surface will change the shape of your cornea and affect the lens measurements that we take in order to calculate the power of lens to put in your eye. And if your eye is especially dry, this may actually give you an unwanted refractive result. Then after cataract surgery, the most common side effect is dry eye. So you want to get on top of this and aggressively treat your dry eye so that your symptoms remain manageable after surgery. You can always start with some over-the-counter, preservative-free artificial tears. And if that isn't enough, you can ask your eye doctor for prescription-strength dry eye medication or any procedures or treatments as indicated. My last tip is to come prepared with questions. Once you leave your appointment, the worst feeling is feeling like you forgot to ask a very important question about your eyes or your eye surgery. Write out your important questions and anything that isn't directly addressed by your eye surgeon, make sure to ask that before you leave. While your eye doctor can help guide your decision on whether or not to pursue cataract surgery at this time, this is ultimately your decision, and preparation ahead of time will help you make the best choices for you and for your eyes. If you enjoy this video, please like and subscribe. I release a new video every Saturday. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.